If you have always wanted to make games in C++ but didn't know how or where to find resources, this video is for you. I will give you some general tips from my experience and then I will tell you what are the best free resources that you can find online in order to start learning all the skills that you need right now. Now, to begin with, the first step that you should take is of course learn how to use the language. However, you don't have to go very deep into it. Let me explain. While I am making games, I usually use the standard library containers like vectors and other structures, but rarely write templates myself, and I never use things like polymorphism or inheritance. By all means, you can use them if you want, but learning advanced C++ shouldn't be your top priority. This brings me to the second step, which is learn how to manage a big codebase. This is very important because games have many systems, and putting them all together can be a challenge. You have probably heard the advice to split your problems into smaller problems, and it is good advice, but people rarely tell you that merging the solutions back is usually something difficult. In order to learn how to handle a big codebase, you have to go to step 3, and this is actually writing a big program. You have probably seen online some advice about design patterns and clean code, but trust me, if you just read about how to structure your code but never actually write a complicated system, you won't make progress. So, what big project should you start on? Well, why not make a game? You probably don't know how to do that, but I'll show you how to start, and then you will learn the rest by doing it. Keep in mind that it is your first big project and you are not making it to sell it on Steam, but rather to learn how to do that. This leads us to the last step, and that is to keep yourself motivated by looking at other people that learned to make games in C++. One video that motivated me was this guy that made Minecraft in 1 week. I really wanted to do that myself, so I started with Terraria, and eventually moved on to making Minecraft myself. It will take a long time, and this is why it is important to remind yourself of the final goal that you pursue. Now, let's talk about what you actually need to learn. The first thing I mentioned is knowing the basics of C++, and if you are unsure how to do that, I recommend you this playlist from the channel, but probably any other tutorial that you can find online will work, because you don't need to go into advanced stuff for this stuff. Next, you need a way to start displaying stuff to the screen in order to make your game. For this, you need two things, a window and a way to draw to it. You can either use a library that will do that for you, or learn to do that yourself with something like Windows API and OpenGL. For this step, I recommend that you use a library, because it will take significantly less time to see some progress. It takes a lot of work to display something to the screen, and if you try to do that yourself, there are some chances that you will get demotivated quickly. I would recommend you two libraries, sfml and raylib, because they are easy to use and they handle window opening, drawing and even sound, so you can play music in your game without configuring another library. sfml has many tutorials online, while raylib is more advanced, and if you learn it, you might also use it for your future projects. Find some videos online that walk you through how to start making your game so you understand how it works. I would recommend you this video series because it teaches you some important basics. After that, you'll have enough knowledge to start making your own game. I said to start it, not finish it. You will gain that knowledge while making it by searching on the internet whenever you get stuck. If you want to learn some more things, however, I also recommend you this channel, JVDX9, sorry for mispronunciation. It has some very well explained tutorials. Before I wrap up, I want to give you a bonus resource, and it is the Handmade Hero series. I think it is the best learning resource for game development, but it is time consuming and rather hard. It teaches you how to do all the things yourself, so if you have enough time and are interested in that sort of stuff, I can recommend you enough watching some of his videos. Now, this was my perspective on how to start doing game development in C++, but different people have different ways of learning. So if you have already completed this journey yourself, feel free to write about it in the comments, and maybe you will help a young future game developer start his own journey. See you next time.